Tesla Gigafactory Texas facility is set to expand by 1.4 million square feet, as the automaker filed over $716 million in new projects at the site. Tesla filed for 4 new projects on January 9, according to filings with the Texas Department of Licensing and Regulation. The projects are filed separately because they will expand 4 different facilities, the filing show. Tesla registered the projects to Cell 1, Drive Unit, Cathode, and Cell Test Laboratory. So as you see, a lot of them have to do with Tesla battery production in Austin. According to the Austin Business Review, which initially spotted the filings, the projects will provide Tesla with 1.4 million additional square feet on site at Gigafactory Texas, and construction could start as soon as the end of the month. The total cost for the 4 new facilities is $716 million, with the bulk of the expenditure coming from the construction of the Cell 1 facility, which is set to cost $368 million. The Cathode building is $260 million, while the Drive Unit and Cell Test Lab buildings will cost $85 million and $3,700,000. Tesla filed the project as new construction. Tesla has been planning to build a cell facility at Gigafactory Texas for some time. On this channel, I've talked about that, I've reported on that. Tesla filed to build a cathode plant at Gigafactory Texas in February 2022, things with Travis Country showed. The cell facility will supplement the automaker's attempts to expand electric vehicle manufacturing in the United States, but will also help Tesla become less dependent on suppliers for its products. Currently, Tesla has numerous battery cell supply deals, most notably with Panasonic in the United States. However, the growth of the electric vehicle market has placed a shortage of battery cells and battery materials, not only for Tesla, but for every automaker. Tesla, which introduced its new 4680 battery cell several years ago, is planning to implement these new batteries into various projects, most notably the Model Y from Gigafactory Texas, which started deliveries to customers last year. Tesla delayed several projects over the past few years because of battery constraints. However, the construction of cathode and cell manufacturing plants at Giga Texas could relieve the company of the shortages as electric vehicle sales expand. And as you know, looks like there are positive signs in China after the recent price cuts. Tesla is also planning to build the Cybertruck in Texas, but the packs are currently being manufactured in Fremont due to the lack of a cell production plant in Austin at Giga Texas. Evidently, Tesla will also be building drive units for its vehicles in Texas. It has built drive units for the Model 3 at the Tesla Gigafactory in Nevada for several years. Now let's move on and see what else is happening with Tesla. Tesla has never considered other electric vehicles as competitors, said the company's vice president in China. Tesla competes only with cars with internal combustion engines, therefore trying to attract consumers to buy its electric vehicles. On January 9th, Grace Tao, the vice president of Tesla, gave an interview to the media in which she spoke about the company's policy, strategy, and pricing. Amid the recent news of price cuts in China and elsewhere, she spoke about Tesla's role in the Chinese automotive market. This was an interesting thing. Tao stressed that the only competition it has is internal combustion engine vehicles, with other electric vehicles being allies, according to Auto Report. Did you see my yesterday's report about BYD saying exactly the same thing and had a really nice attitude? Check it out. Tesla VP said that since January 1 this year, China has canceled the policy of subsidizing the purchases of new energy vehicles, which lasted more than 10 years. This means that every new energy vehicle OEM that sells NEVs is now losing almost 10,000 Chinese yuan profits. And in order to hedge this part of the losses, brands such as BYD, Chery, Changan, Liapo have taken various measures, including price increases. With Tesla cutting prices on its vehicles, talk has begun to surface that this is exacerbating internal friction between NEV manufacturers in China. However, Dow clarified that the company's goal is to fight ICE vehicles, that means gas engine vehicles. First of all, consumers decide whether to buy a car with an internal combustion engine or an electric vehicle. And if they choose an EV, only then do they choose a specific model. She said that we at Tesla have never considered these other electric vehicle companies as competitors. We must work together to make products more extreme and then meet the need of customers in different market segments. Tesla currently produces only two Chinese-made vehicles, but consumers have many different needs that may not be met by just two models, so there is healthy competition in the market. Dow also said the company hopes there will be a variety of electric vehicles on the market that can meet everyone's need. Tesla Model 3 has ended Toyota Camry's 28-year run as the best-selling car in Australia and even drew a small reaction from Toyota. What was that reaction? For the last 28 years, the Camry has been the best-selling mid-size car in Australia and in many parts of the world. It was on a path to make it 29 years, but Tesla delivered 1,806 Model 3 vehicles in December, bringing the total to 10,877 Model 3s in 2022 and beating the Camry, which had only 9,338 units delivered last year. It made the Tesla Model 3 the new best-selling mid-size car in Australia. It's the first time that an electric car has held that title. The change appears to have taken Toyota by surprise, since the automaker still listed the Camry as a best-selling medium car in the country in its press release, bragging about its dominance over the Australian auto market. But it had to add a mention of vehicle for less than $60,000. This is what Toyota said. Toyota vehicles were the best-selling models in 9 market segments last year. Corolla, small cars, Camry, medium cars under $60,000, RAV4, medium SUVs, Land Cruiser Prado, large SUVs, Land Cruiser Wagon, upper large SUVs, Hi-Ace, light buses, Hi-Ace vans, Hilux 4.2 PUCC, and Hilux 4.4 PUCC. The Model 3 starts at $64,000 in Australia compared to $30,000 for the Camry. We are starting to see things like that in more and more markets every year. Quite soon, only electric vehicles are going to be top-selling vehicles, and Toyota is going to need a lot more of them if it still wants to be able to have those lists in its annual press releases. But Toyota has a special attention to electric vehicles, and I've talked about that. Now, the Japanese automaker has been falling behind when it comes to all electric vehicles, as it bet heavily on hybrids, which are just not cutting anymore. Toyota says they want to be a department store where you can find all types of vehicles. Hopefully things like that, where an all-electric vehicle takes a 28-year title away from it, would light a fire under them.